Hey, Bayside family, I hope you're doing well tonight. Wherever you're at, I just hope that you're not feeling too overwhelmed with everything that's happening with this COVID-19. I hope that tonight is going to be a great opportunity for you to just relax and worship God, look into His Word, and I hope you'll be excited for what we have coming up for midweek. I'm going to tell you about that tonight. If you are looking for something to do, make sure that you visit the ministry content page on our church website, www.baysidefamily.church. There's lots of video content and things that we've been doing to try to stay connected with you during this COVID-19 pandemic. Anyways, today we're going to just spend some time as we start worshiping God. So why don't you join with me as we do that?
Breaks the power of sin and darkness. His love is mighty, so much stronger. The King of glory, oh, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, oh, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. For all that you've done for me, who brings our chaos back into order, who makes the orphan a son and daughter, the King of glory, oh, the King of glory, oh, who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of its brilliance, the King of glory, oh, the King above all kings. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. I sing for all that you've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Oh, worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Oh, worthy, worthy, worthy. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is a failing love. I sing for all that you've done for me. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. All that you've done for me. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you, my one defense, righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh God, how I need you.
Well, today I want to introduce you to what we're going to be doing next for our midweek series that we're going to have. And I want to invite you to join along with me, not just once a week, but daily, as we begin to journey through the book of Romans. Now, I know that you're probably thinking this is a lot to cover. And what we're going to do is we're going to take 8 weeks, including this week, and we're going to look through seven of the themes that kind of arise through it. And as we go through the week, I'd like you to join me in reading through the book of Romans. I'd like you to take the time each day to read a portion of the scripture. In the email that you got that has the link to this video, there's a breakdown of how we're going to do it. And I also want you to just keep a journal log or something so that you can remember what you read and the thoughts that you had on it. You can even get something like this. This is a scripture journal specific for Romans that has the passage on one side and some space to write on the other. And I just want to run through Romans together as a group. You know, in the beginning of the Bible starts with God's creation. God's amazing creation that he creates over 7 days, this entire universe. And you know, the most important thing to him, the most significant thing, the best thing he created in all of his creation was humanity. And you know, Adam and Eve were the first people, and as the first people, God made a sort of covenant to them, or a charge to Adam. Let's just read Genesis chapter 2. It says this, verses 15 through 17. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, "You may surely eat of every tree of the garden, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die." You know, we know how the story goes. And we know that Adam didn't keep his end of that charge that God gave him. Adam and Eve messed up. They ate the fruit. Now, you know, we have to think of it this way, though. If Adam and Eve hadn't have made the mistake, somebody somewhere along that way would have. And if nobody had up to this point, I'm pretty sure I would have been the one that would have blown it for everybody. And you know, we see throughout the Old Testament, the Israelites, the people of God, God's chosen people, going one way to serve God the best that they can. And then the next thing you know, they're turning their backs on God and they're not serving him because they want to do things their way. And they're disobeying. And you know, we see this going on over and over, and we see the brokenness of the world that we live in, even today. And you know, we see the need for a Savior. We see the need and the reason why Jesus came. You know, it says in John 3:16, many of you know this, possibly the most popular verse of all time, "For God so loved the world that he sent his only son." You know, as we have been set free because of the cross, from the mistakes that Adam made, and really the brokenness that's been in our world since, you know, I just want to encourage you today to live in the freedom that you have. In Romans, Paul talks about this, and I believe that as we journey through this, you're going to see it. In Romans 5, verses 18 and on, Paul says this. Romans 5, 18 on. He says, "Therefore, as one trespass led to condemnation for all men," this is Adam he's talking about, "so one act of righteousness leads to justification and life for all men." That is Jesus. "For as by one man's disobedience the many were made sinners, so by the one man's obedience the many will be made righteous. Now the law came in to increase the trespass, but where sin increased, grace abounded all the more. So that as sin reigned in death, grace also might reign through righteousness, leading to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." I love this passage of scripture. And you know, as we begin to journey through Romans in the weeks ahead, I think we're going to be reminded and we're going to be encouraged about how God is faithful to his plan, that God is faithful and he's not forsaken his people. As we journey through the world we live in now with COVID-19 around us, we will remember God is faithful to his people. You know, Jesus has given us freedom from death. Through his life, through his death, through his resurrection, we see this beautiful revelation of God's narrative of redemption. And now we are free to live eternally by putting our trust in Jesus Christ. You know, we are sinners, but we can begin the journey. And as we begin this journey through Romans, we're going to be reminded that we don't have to live the way we always have. We don't have to live in brokenness, but we can live in the freedom that we can have in Christ. You know, last week we talked about hope, and I want to encourage you today that this book of Romans is going to be a book that's going to just instill hope in us to know that we can make it because of what Christ did for us. Why don't we pray? Lord, we just thank you for each person here, God. We thank you for the work that was done on the cross. We thank you that the wrongs that have happened in the past can be wiped away and forgotten. And because of you, we can be saved and that your grace is sufficient for us, Lord. We pray that, God, you be with each person wherever they're at today as they journey through this uncertain time of the COVID-19 pandemic that's happening. And God, we pray that you would be our comfort, our strength, our peace, God. We pray that, God, we would look to you, God. And as we begin to journey through Romans, may you show yourself to us in a new way, in a way that is encouraging, in a way that shows us the freedom that we have in Christ. In your name we pray, amen. Have a great week, and I'm just looking forward to reading through Romans with you and seeing what God will do. As you read, if you're starting this week, send me an email, send me a text message, send me some kind of a message. Let me know where you're at and what you're thinking. I'd love to connect with you, and it would be great to keep in touch. God bless. Have a great day.